Alright, check it out. I'm doing a review on the ACU Military 3 sleep system. Put it out here because it's raining. So I'm trying to check out how waterproof it really is. It's 3:45 in the morning. We're gonna see how durable and how waterproof it is. So I'll check you guys in the morning. Well, it is 11:26. So the bag's been out here in the rain. What, seven and change hours? Pretty big puddle. A little puddle right here.
Crucial. Bag is cold.
Wasn't cold. All right, well, I'm gonna get inside and open it up, see how dry it is. All right, dry the bag off. You can't see it, still all beaded up though. Not too bright in here, but let's check out how dry it is in here. And get the Velcro part on the top. I wish I wore some buttons up here, because everything is loose, you know? It doesn't have the snaps on the side. It doesn't have the snaps on top like it does on the side. But it's okay. Man, this joint is dry. Cold, but dry. This joint looks pretty...
pretty dry. Damn.
Dry, kid.
That's crucial.
So that's the inner layer.
Undo the snaps.
Check out the first one that was up against the Gore-Tex. Look at that, man. I don't know if you can tell, but dry. Just a little bit of moisture there.
Alright. Change the camera position. But yeah, man, waterproof, and we're lying. And I know you saw, well, I hope you saw, the huge puddle on top. Look at that, man, dry. That's what's up, man. So I'm really happy I got one of these. So I was trying to figure out the difference between this one and the woodland camo. Obviously you have the digital camo, compared to the woodland camo, and the two bags on the inside are different. Well, a different color, because you would have the black and the green one. But apparently these are the newer version. This is the sleep system all wrapped up in the compression bag. The difference it has to the woodland camo one is that the compression bag seals up at the top just with this drawstring. This one, which I like a lot, it's not fully compressed now, so it's probably not going to work, but it's got this sort of cover that goes over top. Oh, check it out, it did work. And then you clip it in here. So you can cinch it down even more. And I think that's cool because, you know, on the other one, seen on videos and just on the internet by checking them out, I see the drawstring and then the compression ties that run along the sides, but that's it, you know. But with this one, it's got this little cover, so I like that a lot. I like the black compression bag better though, in being black, but I like this design better. So can't have everything. So that's that. And that's about, you look it up, it's about like 10 to 12 pounds, you know? It's way heavier than than hiking mummy bags. But waterproof. Inside, let me see. Right here, you know, it's got the tag. I read it somewhere. Here, joining bags by placing the urban gray bag inside of the foliage green bag and affixing the two at all attachment points. Use only the green bag zipper to enter and exit. The configuration will protect from minus 10 to minus 50 degrees Fahrenheit when used with two layers of extreme cold weather system. Use a bivy cover for protection from rain, snow, or wind. So, you know, on everything I've read of the woodland camo one, it's from minus 10 to like minus 30. So, you know, this one's minus 10 to minus 50 degrees Fahrenheit. I'm sure they mean with, you know, the proper attire, clothing also. But I'm looking forward to the snow this fall, so I can try it out in the winter. But waterproof, 100%, man. 100%. You saw the puddle on top. I lifted this up. Dry. Dry as anything. So, definitely glad I got it. 100%.